Hey there, it's Kaylee. Now we're going to learn how to solve one-step inequalities using multiplication and division. Ready? Let's go! Here we have an inequality that says 4y is greater than or equal to 16. And we need to solve for the variable and then graph the solution. So what do we need to do first? Yeah, we need to get this y all by itself. So we have to undo times 4. How do we undo times 4? That's right, we divide. So I'm going to divide this side by 4. And as we've learned, what I do to one side of the inequality, I have to do to the other side of the inequality. So when I go ahead and do my arithmetic, I get y is greater than or equal to 16 divided by 4 is 4. So now I'm going to go ahead and graph my solution. I do that by getting out my number line here. We'll say here is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and over here we have negative 1. We know that this direction of our number line goes all the way to negative infinity, and over here we go all the way to positive infinity. So if I'm going to plot my solution set, where do I start on my number line? Yeah, right here at the 4, so I draw my circle there. Do I fill it in? Yes, how come? Because 4 is included in my solution set, because it's or equal to. And what direction does the arrow go? Well, y is greater than or equal to 4, so includes all the numbers that are greater than 4. Perfect. Now we can double check this by plugging in one of our solutions. What's a number that's part of our solution set? Yeah, how about this 5 right here? So if we say y is equal to 5 and we plug it into our inequality here, we will have 4 times 5, we use substitution, is greater than or equal to 16. 4 times 5, that gives us 20 greater than or equal to 16. Is that true? Is 20 greater than or equal to 16? It sure is. So we did it right. This time we have an inequality that looks like x over 3. Remember, x over 3 is the same as saying x divided by 3 is less than 5. We gotta solve for our variable, so solve for x and then graph our solution. So how do I undo x over 3 or x divided by 3? Yeah, I can multiply, right? So if I multiply over here by 3, what do I do over here? The same thing, multiply by 3. So my 3s will cancel out. I'm left with x is less than 5 times 3 is 15. So we solved for our variable, and now we got to plot our solution or graph our solution. Because this number is pretty big at 15, on my number line I'm going to count by 5s. So I don't have to write so many numbers down. And we go in the negative direction over here. Alrighty. So x is less than 15. Where do I start my graph? At the 15, open circle or closed circle? Open circle. How come? Yeah, because 15 isn't actually included in my solution set, right? It's like 14.9999. All those nines keep going on forever, right? But it never gets all the way to 15. And then my solution set is all the numbers that are less than 15. So my arrow will point towards the left, including all of the numbers that are smaller than 15. Cool. Should we do a test here? What is a number that is part of our solution set? We can substitute in to double check. How about this 0 right here? What would happen if x is equal to 0? Well, we'd have 0 over 3 is less than 5. What's 0 divided by 3? 0. Is 0 less than 5? Is that true? It sure is, so we can be certain that our answer is correct. Awesome, now you can solve one-step inequalities with multiplication and division. Go ahead and practice on your own, have fun, and remember to always be clever.